the amount of like fortune that this guy gets too.
Yeah.
Not just in terms of gold and like the amount of times where it's like things just went in his way, dude.
Just kind of worked out for him, dude. Just kind of worked out for him, man.
It's fucking nuts,
He's
dude.
Got the Midas touch, dude.
Yes. Like, dude, I'm fucking amped, dude. I fucking watched Apocalypto last night, dude.
Jaguar paw, dude.
This is my motherfucking forest, dog.
Hey, and man.
My son and his sons will hunt this forest after I'm gone.
Yeah.
Dog.
Yeah, man. I just remember that scene where they're beyond that cornfield is your forest.
Yeah.
Yeah, that scene, dude, is nuts, dude.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Which doesn't make, like, I think the first people that you see run, because his buddy, his big bastard buddy, Blunted, he runs with some other asshole, and they just run in the straight line.
Yeah.
But you're like, everyone would just, like, figure eight, dude. Or something, yeah, dude. But that movie's fucking, it's great, dude. Still
yeah.
holds up, man. And then obviously at the end, you see.
You see the conquistadors,
dude. You see these fucking gigantic ships. Jesus, man. But yeah, man, we're talking a little fall of the.
1485!
the fall of the Aztec Empire, brought to you by Cortes. Hernan Cortes. Hernan
Cortes, dude. First of all, Hernan. It's a decent name, dude.
It's a decent name. There's
if he wasn't a Spanish guy, I'd be like, that name's fucking stupid, dude. Because, you know, I hate to bring it back to one of the five things we always talk about, but in The Sopranos, there's a dude named Hernan that was AJ's friend when they're like going out clubbing and shit.
Okay.
And he
was
just the biggest piece of shit.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Those names, I mean, there's people that you meet or you see in life that,
yeah,
it can be in a show like that, dude, 100%.
Yeah, man.
But yeah, Hernan Cortes.
Cortes, born 1485 to a lower nobility family in Spain. This class was also called the Hidalgos. I thought it was interesting.
For real, dog?
Yeah. So, like, nobility that didn't own land.
I've seen that movie.
Yeah. Yeah, man. What is that movie even about?
It's about a horse named Hidalgo.
Hell yeah, dude. A fucking Spanish horse that conquered
yeah.
the goddamn whole of Mexico, dude.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Is that what it's about? Animated?
I mean, yeah, the horse turns into a transformer and just fucking slaughters everybody, dude. But yeah, he didn't come from much, but like he did have like connects.
Yeah,
he had connections.
Technically, they were still nobility,
yeah.
even though they were not rich family. They had
right.
They were still in the mix.
His old man was like kind of like a better known war veteran who'd gotten into some shit. You know, had a couple notches on his belt. You know, I think Hernan was. I think Cortes was. A bastard, too. I'm pretty sure he just...
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I think his dad just getting into some holes, dude.
Yeah, well, that's a recurring theme in his life as well, dude. Just...
yeah. But Cortes, born from...
you spread your seed wherever you can.
He's born, kid grows up, he's kind of a... Like all these European fucks, he's a pale, scraggly, you know, sickly-looking young man, young boy, known to be a little mischievous, get into some trouble. He was
a fucking shithead teenager.
Yeah,
put it that way, dude.
Yeah, that's pretty much
it. He was a fucking shithead. He was kind of smart, you know, he had decent family connections, but he was just like getting into trouble.
Yeah.
Trying to bang chicks, dude.
Yeah. Well, dude, that's just it. He was a charmer. Like, he didn't look like much, but that fucking silver tongue on him,
I like this guy.
Yeah.
You need a job, dude? I like you, dude.
There's accounts of people being like, dude, you just like walk into a room wanting to rip his head off.
Yeah.
And you'd leave just like forgetting why you walked in there.
Right.
But yeah, just like regular, scraggly looking little guy and had the ability to just manipulate people to an extent. But like.
Cunning.
Yeah. Get him on the side, you know?
Yeah. And just real quick, like the world at this time, you know. Was just like very like if you because Spain was just they had just driven out all the Muslims and retaken basically the entirety of Spain, signed a deal with Portugal
against the Moors, right? Wasn't that the
I don't know, just it's just I don't know, we kind of covered that a little bit in the touched on it in our Crusades episode. So this is like after the Crusades.
Yep.
The Inquisition is just popping off in Spain.
Right.
They're about to reclaim the last piece of the Iberian Peninsula, completely drive out the Muslims.
Yeah.
So Spain's like big dick all of a sudden. Like,
dude.
They're like, what's up, dude? They got Naples. They got Sicily. That's all their shit, dude. Like,
yeah.
They just signed a deal with the Holy Roman Empire. They're like, your son will marry our daughter.
Yeah, dude.
And then we will be in control, dude.
Right.
Yeah. And also, you got the new world, man.
Yeah.
So if you're like a young guy, you're like, fuck all this shit, dude.
Yeah.
Like, I want to go get rich, man.
That's just it.
It's kind of the same idea as the Crusades. Like, dude, there's adventure out there.
Right. Yeah. So, like, that's just it. Like, exactly what you're saying. So, like, by the time Cortez was, like, 14, he'd gone to, like, go study...
law.
Go study what his parents thought it was going to be, law.
Right.
But he's just, like, hanging out with his uncle. He's in Salamanca, and he's just, like... not studying.
Where the bitch is at.
Yeah, dude. He's just doing everything, but he's doing what every fucking college dropout did.
he's just hanging out and partying.
Yeah, dude. You're like in a new fucking place, dude. You're just like, fuck this. But that's just it. Like, all this that you're hearing, like, Columbus is just fucking, like, word of Columbus is just getting back to Spain.
Yeah.
That he'd fucking, you know, he just found some new shit. Album's about to drop.
Yeah.
It's gonna be fucking fire, dude.
Yeah, man.
So 2 years later, he like comes back from hanging with his uncle. He was studying Latin. That's what he was doing, which is that's the class that everybody says that they're taking, but he comes back 2 years later after he's in Salamanca and his parents were pretty much like empty nesters, and they were like, what are you doing?
You came back?
What are you doing, dude?
What the fuck?
I'm trying to bury my beak here, son. So, his parents were like, aren't you supposed to fucking be a lawyer, dude? Like, what the fuck? But he used those 2 years in Salamanca. Basically, the cover was that he was like learning Latin, and then what he was really doing was like training to get some experiences like a notary. That's what he ended up really fucking doing. So he first did that in Valladolid and then later in Hispaniola.
Yeah, which is Haiti, Dominican Republic.
Correct.
Modern.
And
so he left. He's like, fuck it, dude. I'm going.
That's right. But the important thing that he learns while he's like with his uncle there, learning all this shit as a notary that helps him later in life, is like learning all that shit gave him the knowledge of like the legal codes. So then he applied that shit way after
That's right.
To like justify the things we're gonna get.
He does it a couple of times actually.
Yeah.
To like, yeah, exactly.
So he's like, by the time he's fucking 16, he's just like, fuck you, mom and dad. Like, I'm fucking leaving. I'm going to go become a colonist.
They're like, good.
Yeah.
Like, get the fuck out of here, dude. Like,
but already he's got, like, this reputation of, like, we were talking, like, even when he was a kid to now he's getting into his later adulthood of being just like a ruthless little fuck and just being smooth talking. He could just always get his way. So, the guy just keeps on climbing the corporate ladder kind of thing, man.
Yeah.
Like the people that he knows, they're kind of helping him get jobs. And
it's just all connections.
Dude. Yeah. He's the fucking, he's like the trust fund kid without any of the money.
That's, yeah. Yeah, dude.
Whose nephew is this?
He's got a fucking chip on his shoulder.
Yeah.
And he's rising the ranks, dude.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, man.
So by the time he gets back home, oh, we kind of talked about that.
Yeah, we talked about. He's in, you said he's in, sorry, not Cuba, Hispaniola.
Yeah, he was in Hispaniola. But yeah, we talked, dude, the news of Columbus was getting back. That, so right around when he was 16, I think, that's when the Columbus, like, they're hearing back from, word is getting back to Spain that, you know, Columbus is just making all sorts of friends with the Arawaks. And he had to get out. That's kind of what you were saying. Like, that's what I wanted to get to. That's what you were saying. Like, he felt so, like, restrained. He was like, dude, I got to get the fuck out of here. I got to go.
I got to go be something, dude.
Yeah, 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 yeah. So, when he feels that way, he's pretty much just like, I'm going to get the fuck out of Spain. I'm going to get on a ship to Hispaniola, right? 1504?
Yep.
1504, he finally leaves Spain, and he's going to Hispaniola. And he's on a ship there with his fella named Alonso Quintero, who he kind of becomes like the influence because like Quintero is being told by some of his superiors and whatnot, like, hey, you got to like make sure, you know, you leave on this day like the rest of us, bro, because we all want to get there at the same time. We all want to get, you know, the same parking space right next to each other.
Yeah.
And fucking Quintero's like, yeah, we're straight, like, dude. Yeah. Like, yeah, we'll be there.
Yeah, of course, man.
And, like, they all plan to, like, leave.
And they turn around. He's like, fucking faggots. Yeah. Fucking pussies, dude. And they're like, what's up? What's up?
Yeah.
He's like, nothing, dude. I'll see you, dude. I'll save you a seat.
Yeah. We're leaving in March. We're leaving in March, bro. And he's like,
you go fucking collect your shit, dude.
Yeah.
I'm sure shit not ready to go yet.
Yeah.
I wouldn't leave without you. I wouldn't do that.
So that's one of the things that fucking Cortez just picks up right away from Quintero. Like, just like, dude, you gotta look out for numero uno. Okay, yeah. Dude. So in this particular occasion, what he sees was Quintero leaves to go to Hispaniola. And everybody's supposed to leave like in March, and Quintero leaves like in fucking end of January.
He's like, and he's just fucking idiots.
He just,
let's go.
He just takes all the shit right away. Like all the supplies that these natives have and they bring to them, like, and sign a piece. It's like, we're just going to take all of it. So, like, that just becomes a habit of Cortez ultimately.
Oh, hey, can I kick in here with just one quick detail?
Yeah.
So, the exploration of the New World is being financed by the crown. Mm. So they give you all the money to get ships and all the fucking supplies. And then what they want in return is 1/5 of whatever you get.
Un quinto. That's what they would call it.
Yeah.
El quinto. You're 1/5.
Yeah. And when I read that, the guy had a funny accent. Or when I listened to that particular detail in the audiobook, the guy had a funny accent. So he said, like, the crown's fief. And I was like, what? What the fuck is that?
Yeah.
And then I finally got it, and I just kept going, fief. Fief. Send the fief back to the crown.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Fief. Yeah. So whatever gold, whatever you got, 20% of the loot, dude. Yeah. Send it back.
Right.
That was basically the deal.
Right.
Yeah.
That was huge too. Like, one of the things that we'll get to towards the end too is like how important. I mean, dude, that was. I mean, that's like so fucking. I mean, that's the government. That's mafia anywhere. Anything you do, you know, we got to get our fucking chunk of it. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So yeah, I mean, going back, Quintero's basically just like, dude, we're taking all this, dude. That's he right, told all dude. Those guys back there. He was like, dude, we want to hit the beaches when they're, you know, nice and cool,
fucking
dude.
Fucking relax, dude.
Yeah.
What the fuck was that, dude?
Was that the lights or was that like...
No, dude. That was that had to have been a fucking bird or something, dude. Sorry for that. So
fucking Batman just flew.
Yeah, dude. The entire window just blacked out. What the fuck was that? That had to have been like a fucking giant bird, dude.
Just a giant
a hawk or something.
Flying
man.
Bat, dude. All right. So, yeah. So, Cortez going from like 16 to 18 now. He gets to become the... He gets to the capital of Hispaniola, which is Santo Domingo. He registers as a citizen. And, dude, as a citizen... You're entitled to a building plot and land to farm on as an 18-year-old, dude.
Hell yeah, dude.
Dude, you get a fucking bachelor
out
pad.
Of mom's basement, dude.
Out of mom's basement. I got my own place, dude. I set up my PS4 here,
bring
dude.
Bring the brews, dude. Watch the fucking game.
Man. Yeah, man.
Yeah, yeah.
So he is... As an 18-year-old, just, like, living the goddamn life at this point.
Yeah, big time.
Like, everything is going great, making a name for himself. So, like, in the next couple years, they just end up taking, you know, more land, rape, pillage, murder, indoctrinate, condition, you know, tribe to tribe to tribe. Any tribe that needs Jesus, they're just going around.
That's right, dude.
Fucking... Making sure that it's just they kneel to the cross, dude.
Yeah.
I literally saw a truck today at a gas station, and it said, "We stand for the flag, and we kneel for the cross." And it had an eagle.
That's fucking hardcore, dude.
And just, dude, the guy driving had
it had an eagle with a fucking M16, dude.
Yeah, yeah. It had the two towers still standing, dude.
Yeah, yeah.
The guy driving. This fucking jackass, just the camouflage hat. I just wanted to salute him, man, with, you know, my middle finger.
Yeah.
But,
should have accused him of stolen valor, dude. Those are the funniest fucking videos, man.
Oh, my God. Dude, what? They got videos of people, like, just...
Yeah. You can find a ton of those on YouTube, man. It's always some, like, Marine or something who's just, like, at the mall with his kids. And then, like, the video starts, like, all right, so you see this guy, like, 30 feet away? He's fucking bullshit, dude. And it's always a dude, full uniform. And then, like, he goes up to the guy. He goes, "What's up, bro?" And then, like, starts just asking him questions. Be like, "Where'd you serve?" Blah, blah, blah. Jeez. And then he goes... "Why do you have two of those patches?" "Nobody has two of those patches."
Yeah.
And the guy, oh, dude, it becomes so fucking cringe. Dude, he'd be like, "Where'd you get those boots, man? Those are not official boots." Like,
oh my God.
Just starts going down every detail. And then, you know, of course, finally he calls it, "You're fucking bullshit, bro." And he goes, no, I just got back, man. And he's like, "No, you fucking didn't, dude. Where'd you get that?" Like, yeah, it's pretty sad.
That's rough, dude. That's like, I've seen the ones where
it's always some fat guy with glasses. Always. Always.
You just desperately wanted to, like, be his character in Call of Duty. Like, dude, I'm that good. I can be that good. I just need the uniform.
Yeah. Like, it's nuts, man.
It's like the other videos like that are the fucking guys who claim to be black belts, like in jiu-jitsu or
yes.
something. Yes. Those are great, yes. dude. Some, like, cop guy coming in to instruct. And he's like, "I'm black belt in jiu-jitsu, black belt in Krav Maga, purple belt in taekwondo." And, like some guy tells his buddy that he's, like, all these stats. And one of them's like, "Dude, there's no fucking purple belt in fucking Jeet Kune Do. What the fuck are you talking about?"
Yeah, man.
It's like, "I'm going to go check this out." And he's, like, an actual black belt. And then he just, like... It looks like a fucking ape going around in a circle.
Yeah,
he's
yeah.
like, "I couldn't quite find positioning." So it's like, dude, get the fuck out.
It's always like very, just weird excuses.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right.
So yeah, from Hispaniola, he goes to Cuba in 1511.
Wait.
Yeah.
Real quick detail.
Yeah, dog.
So he does become a notary over there because he, you know, he starts making connections with everybody.
Yep, yep.
And I forget what these fucking people are called. It's basically like encomienda.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. I saw something
so
about
basically
that.
Like, it's like they're slaves, basically. Yeah, they're like yeah. local.
Right.
They're
right.
local tribes people. So, like, he gets granted, like, his own little spot. They're like, why don't you go be the notary of this, I forget what the town's called. And here's, like, 12 slaves, dude.
Yeah.
So, like, he's steadily rising. Yeah. That's all I wanted to say.
No, for sure, yeah. for sure. And that's, I mean, the amount of, like, fortune that this guy gets, too.
Yeah.
Not just in terms of gold and, like, the amount of times where it's, like, things just went in his way, dude.
Just kind of worked out for him, dude. Just kind of worked out for him, man.
It's fucking nuts,
he's
dude.
He's got the Midas touch, dude.
Yes, like, yes. So last we left off here, he's got some slaves. He's 18, living his life, moved out of parents' basement. So from Hispaniola, Cortez goes to Cuba in 1511. Now I think in his 20s, right? I think roughly around there.
Yeah,
something like
yeah,
that.
Yeah.
And this is where things get a little interesting here. So, the governor of New Spain, which is Mexico, like some part of Mexico, I believe, I don't even think it's there just yet, but they gave these fucking guys all sorts of different titles. Anyways, Diego Velasquez, and
he's the big chief over there.
He's the big chief. He's the governor. I believe he's the governor of Cuba. At this point.
He's the governor of Cuba.
Yeah, that's what it is. And he stays there. Cortez stays there for like 15 years. Becomes like a big fucking swinging dick there, dude. Okay?
Yeah, he becomes the... He becomes in charge of... what did you call it? The fifth? The one, crown fifth?
The quinto.
He becomes in charge of collecting all that.
Damn! Yeah. Oh, which he's not. He's definitely making sure every penny's accounted for.
Nah, yeah, of course, dude.
Yeah.
You know, just sack of gold here and there, dude. You know, got to grease palm somehow, dude.
Yeah,
you know
dude.
You what I'm saying, man?
But, yeah, you know, guy just keeps climbing and climbing, gaining more power. But the more this dude keeps gaining power, more Cortez is, you know, getting... Some big dick energy. Fucking Velasquez is like
the governor of Cuba.
Governor of Cuba's like, I don't know if I like this guy, dude.
Yeah, it's described as him becoming a rival and less of a subordinate each day.
Yeah,
more and more.
And people, I imagine, see them as like, oh, they're like the two main guys here.
They're the bros.
Running the show. Things, you know, they got a good handle on things, but like internally, there's just like this, hey, nice job on that.
Yeah.
You know, on that rape today. You guys brought in some numbers. I imagine it's something
like biting his lower lip. He's like, good fucking job, dude.
He likes him because he gets shit done, but like, he's like,
he's a top earner.
Yeah, dude. He's fucking Ralphie. He's fucking Ralphie from The Sopranos. He hates his fucking guts, but he's the best earner.
Yes. Yes, dude. So ultimately what happens, because these guys have this relationship, Cortez, like you were mentioning earlier, just fucking chasing skirts. But yeah, like, dude, he kind of is like chasing the wrong skirt for a while, and it bites him in the ass because it ends up being Velasquez's.
So like
sister-in-law or something, right?
Right, because there's conflicting information about how this woman was actually related to Velasquez. So
yeah,
because like we should say real quick too, where all this information comes from is like four main sources. It's one Franciscan monk who wrote like this huge history of all these expeditions. Two is all of Cortez's correspondence back to the crown.
Yeah.
Three is one of his soldiers. So that comes later. That doesn't even describe this period of time. Like 50 years later after all this shit went down,
right,
before he's about to die. And then I forget the last one. There was one more.
But like, so there's a lot of conflicting information.
Well, all of this, dude.
Yeah.
For sure, because as what it was the...
Just write notes, put it on a ship, and send it back to...
Exactly.
And the queen's probably like, yeah, cool, man. Just fucking throw it in the pile, dude.
Right, right. So he ends up... This woman who is in some way connected closely...
I think it's his daughter-in-law.
Something like that. Yeah. So... Velasquez is like, hey, you know, you keep fucking her, you're going to have to marry her.
He's like, what the
fuck? And Cortez is like,
he's like,
oh, fuck, you're serious.
Velasquez, dude, you fucking kill me, dude. He's like, what are we doing now, man?
Yeah.
Here's a fucking, here's this week's sack of gold, dude.
Yeah, you got to quit fucking me around like that.
Yeah, dude, you had me. You almost had me.
He's like, Velasquez is giving him the death stare, so... And he's like, Velasquez is his superior, so like...
He's like, shit.
Shit, yeah. He fucking ends up marrying this broad, dude.
She's a six. Like, he's like in the bar. He's in the bar talking to his buddies like, she's a fucking six at best, dude. On her best day.
On her best day, she's a six, dude. Well,
what the fuck were you doing? And I was, I don't know. I fucked up. You fucked up a lot, dude.
Dude, it's fucking Janice, dude. That's who.
It's Janice, yeah. It's fucking Janice Soprano, dude.
So, reluctantly marries this fucking woman. He knows it would send a good message, basically, to Velasquez. Good message to the crown. You know, we got this guy kind of in order. He's doing his job, and now he's looking to settle down, you know. Velasquez, he sends two assholes to the mainland, to Mexico first, on two expeditions to colonize it before Cortez.
Yeah, because they're getting wind of riches, basically. All these gold riches.
Yeah.
Like, out west.
Right.
And they're like, all right, let's fucking do it. Yeah. Like, yeah, man.
Yeah.
What was this guy's name? I fucking wrote it down, dude.
One of the conquistadors?
Yeah, the guy who goes first. I don't know, he goes up against the Mayans. What was that guy's name?
I don't think I got his name.
De Grijalva?
Maybe.
Juan de Grijalva. I think that was him.
Okay.
I think that was his name.
So this is the guy that they first sent.
Okay. And they're not really clear on, like, what to do, what the instructions of the exploration are. Because a lot of them, they're like, rape and pillage, take whatever you can. Some are like, you know, just establish a base, you know, establish language connections in the area. They don't really tell him what to do. So he ends up going over there and going toe-to-toe with the Mayans and loses, like, half his fucking guys.
Right.
And just goes back with his tail between his legs.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But the other guy has some success, doesn't he?
Yes. But like, and you probably got some shit on this. It's not going, still not going as well as Velasquez wants.
That's it.
Yeah.
So one of these assholes, he does come back and he's like, yo, I did set up a colony. There's money. There's bitches. Silver and gold all up in here.
He's like, Mexico. Is tight.
It's lit, bro. It's lit. Yeah. And he's like, it's just a thing, like, I can't completely lock it down here. So Velasquez, governor of Cuba, is like,
he does one of these, oh, fuck. God damn it, dude. All right. Bring in Cortez, dude.
Yeah. He's like, Cortez, I'm fucking calling you up to the
big. Yeah, place. Go to the whorehouse on 5th. My fucking son-in-law is probably sleeping on the floor in his own a pool of his own urine, dude. Pick him up and bring him back here, dude. I gotta talk to him.
Cortez is God being woken it, up dude. By someone kicking him, yeah. And he's like, "I'm not here. What is, like,
huh?
Here's some gold, bitch.
Yeah, go away. Throwing coins at people.
Here's some cab fare. Yeah, Velasquez calls him up to the big leagues, and he appoints him captain general on this next expedition. But he tells
What did they call it, though? Caradillo or something? Caradillo? I forget what the official title was.
Oh, I don't know.
Yeah, I didn't.
On some of these, for like most, and
there's, there's too much, too many fucking names.
That's it. Dude. That's why, like, I avoided most of those to be like, get to the main thing.
Yeah.
Because
yeah.
like the city, like there's like
there's a million cities, a million yeah, tribes. Like,
right, right, right.
Yeah, yeah.
But again, dude, fucking Velasquez. As soon as he's like,
it's like, God damn it,
you're dude. Telling me you need. An extra hand, dude. Fucking A. So he reluctantly gets Cortez. He's like, dude, listen.
He makes Ralphie captain. Yeah. Dude, this is fucking Ralphie from The Sopranos.
Yes, he's it
like,
is, dude.
He comes to me. He's like, T, I got to know that it was on merit and not because somebody fucked up and died. He's like, just fucking go, man.
Yeah. Yeah. So, yeah, well, he tells him, he's like, go before I change my fucking mind.
He's like God you need damn it, to get... dude. I fucking hate you.
But yeah.
I know you can do this.
Yeah. And, like, the thing, too, is, like, Cortez has been in the game so fucking long.
He's like...
He has seen and witnessed, like, bad expeditions, good expeditions. And, dude, the guy just...
He's collecting all the coin, dude.
Yeah.
He knows what's up.
So
yeah.
After all this, like, he knew exactly how to not fuck things up.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So by the time Velasquez tells him, hey, dude, I'm sending you on this fucking mission. Go before I change my mind. Dude, Cortez already had like a foot on the boat, dude. Like he was ready to fucking roll.
What's
dude.
Up? Yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. We're doing it.
Right. And in a matter of, like, I think a month, fucking Cortez gets 6 ships, 300 men.
I read 500.
Well, here's the thing. So he gets these 6 ships, 300 okay. men, and Velasquez is, like, chilling, and all of a sudden one of his people comes and wakes him up and is like, boss man, Cortez is not fucking around. Like, he's ready to leave now. He's like... It's been like 30 days. There's no fucking way.
Yeah.
And he's like, bro, he's ready to leave right now.
Yeah.
So Velasquez gets up, goes over there, and is like, dude, this is bullshit. Let me see some receipts. This is impossible. Yeah. Like, there's no way you could have set this up this fast. Like, I'm giving this to Phil and risk management, but, like, Cortez is, like, one step ahead of him already. And... Like, what he had already learned from who we mentioned before, Quintero, of just being like, dude, go fuck yourself. He actually had more men than that guy had reported. So the original report was that. And then it turns out that he had fucking more shit. And Velasquez was like trying to stop him before he could fucking set sail. And he just fucking peaced out. He was like, fuck it, I'm off to the new world, motherfucker. Like, just left.
Yeah.
So this is February of 1519.
Real quick.
Yeah.
All right. So he brought also 13 horses.
Yes.
A fuckload of cannons, steel weapons, which is crucial.
Right.
We'll get to that later. And then the last one was war dogs.
Yeah.
Massive fucking mastiffs. Irish wolfhounds and mastiffs, dude. You ever seen an Irish wolfhound?
Isn't it like a...
They can only live... They live to like 6 or 7. Because they weigh like 150 pounds. And they're like... If they go up on their back feet, they're like 6'3", 6'5".
Jesus
they're
Christ,
massive
dude.
Fucking dogs, man.
I've heard of them and I think I've seen a couple of pictures of them. But like, I've never witnessed... Because dude, I mean... All the Mexicans had at this time too, mind you, for dogs... were fucking chihuahuas.
Oh, for real?
Swear to God. That's why chihuahuas are fucking yappy fucks. Because
yeah.
They, and the Romans used them too, I think, if I'm not mistaken.
Interesting.
They used them as guard dogs. Those were their fucking... Because they just... You know?
Yeah. And then you kick them and it's all over for them.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. But so just to go back to... So Velasquez says, fuck that, you're not going. And then he takes off, obviously.
Right.
But before that... Velasquez designates another guy to take over the mission. That guy was mysteriously murdered before Cortez left.
Yeah.
Dude, Cortez is just this dude.
He's like, he's oh, you give my mission to somebody else, huh?
Yeah.
That's fucking weird because it's mine, dude. And they're like, whatever. You're fucking done.
Yeah. That's fucking nuts. I didn't know that.
And they're like, sir, Cortez has left. And they're like, what about Cadrone, who we assigned? Cadrone is dead. He's fucking dead, dude. Yeah.
So now we go into landing fucking, what do they call that? You don't land on a boat. They come to shore.
Oh, I don't know. Yeah, you know, you park a mile out, half mile out.
What do they call that?
And then you come in canoes, man. Yeah, yeah. Smaller ships.
Jesus, dude. That's still how it's done, right?
Like, they don't really do like beach arrivals anymore.
That's true. I'm a fucking idiot. I just realized how childish that fucking is. Like a big boat just right on the sand. Yeah,
that would be cool. I'm not going to lie, dude.
That would just fuck up the entire beach.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, that makes sense now. So, yeah, these guys arrive in Mexico, okay? And these pale, pasty Spanish sickly bastards land first in what we know now today is Cozumel. And they head, I think they just pick up some shit there. And then they head south to the coast of Mexico. And they're wearing just, dude, these fucking guys are coming from Spain. Also, a real sidebar of just how dumb I am. I watched the Chris Rock special. Which one is it? The one where it's black people versus
Bring the Pain?
I think it might be Bring the Pain.
Bigger and Blacker or Bring
it
the
wasn't
Pain?
It wasn't Bigger and Blacker, but it was probably Bring the Pain. But I remember his joke about just like Africans going from Africa to the United States.
Right.
And he'd just be like, that is far. All I know is that it's far. And he's like, there's still slaves on their way here. And for some dude, I was like, dude, from Spain to Mexico, that has to take like 2 years, which it doesn't. It's like it's like a month or something.
Yeah, I don't think it takes a long fucking time.
It takes a long time. But I was like in this stupid childish
brain of mine, I got you.
Thinking it takes way longer. So anyways,
you're going off your Chris Rock.
I'm going off my Chris Rock. Yeah. So these fucking pale Spanish bastards arrive in the fucking hot, steamy, sunny, bright jungles of fucking the south coast of Mexico, okay? And they're like wearing their armor.
Yeah, they're covered in steel, dude, steel armor. Which is funny because, like, they came from Cuba. Like,
you're right, right.
You think,
right.
Like, they kind of have an idea.
Yeah,
of what
yeah,
the
you're climate. Right.
It might be cold. Bring your North Faces.
Does anyone have my Patagonia?
Yeah.
They also thought they were going to fucking China or something. I think they thought they were going to the...
Yeah, dude, I got they some, just... They just like...
None of these guys knew where they were going.
They
Columbus,
didn't know where they were going.
Fucking all these conquistadors, they don't know where the fuck they're going. But they thought it was a island off of China. It was a big island off of China. And I mean, they had no idea they were in Mexico. And they had no idea that they were, like, in North America. So these guys just arrive, and they're just in their heavy armor, fucking swatting mosquitoes, and just in a dense, dense, hot fucking jungle of bullshit. Also, there's, like, did you read about Cortez burning his boats?
Yeah, that's hilarious, dude. He's like, all right, fellas, are we doing this or what? And they're like, yeah, you know, I hope it works out. And he's like, not good enough, dude. Turn around. And all his ships were on fire. And he's like, no way out of this shit, dude. It's either all or nothing, dude.
Yeah. So that's called scuttling your ship.
Yeah.
But it turns out it was like... Again, going back to what you were saying, like the reports of this, the history of this, dude, you never hear the side of the loser, okay?
Right.
You know, so right.
the Aztecs, the Mayans, all these natives that were here, there's very, very small portions of history of, you know, their people talking about what actually happened here. So it turns out that, yeah, he did scuttle his ships, but, like, he used those to set, like, he didn't, like, set them ablaze. He, like, tore them apart to set up his colony, to, like, build little houses and huts. And
set shit. The tone, though, also with your troops, like, bro, we're doing this. Yeah. Like,
that's right.
It's too fucking late for you to go home.
Yeah, dude. Yeah. Let me see here. Oh, and before this, I guess he stopped in Trinidad and Cuba to hire. Oh, this is where that number. So, like, he picked up. There was more people reported than what he thought. And then he did stop in Trinidad and Cuba.
Get slaves.
To get more slaves, more people. So this motherfucker shows up with 11 ships, 500 men, including seasoned slaves, and 13 horses, a couple of cannons, and a can-do attitude.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly.
But yeah, he tore apart the boats, which I'm sure is like extremely psychological damage on those fucking people.
They're just like, damn it, dude. Like, I thought this was going to last a couple months. Yeah. Like, it's like, dude, I have a wife. Like,
I told her I'd bring her something back, dude.
Yeah, what the fuck?
Oh, shit. But he ends up finding, well, like, one of the first things that Cortez... did you have something on, like, when they first arrived?
I got really nothing until we kind of get going here.
All right. So then one of the first people he kind of, like, interacts with was a Spanish priest
who survived
a shipwreck.
This is what I was going to talk about.
And he'd escaped, like, Mayan captivity.
And yeah, this guy's awesome, dude. He pulls a fucking jaguar paw, dude. So his ship, he gets shipwrecked, and he's like, they wash up on the shore with, like, you know, 20 guys and some women. And a Mayan tribe captures them. And they're just like, well, make all the women slaves. And all the men are getting their hearts ripped out in the fucking town square. And then he's like, shit. And luckily, they only do like 5 guys, but like he realizes like he's next. So him and this other dude escape to a neighboring tribe who are, thankfully enough, warring with the tribe who ripped out the hearts of his buddies. And they made him a slave also, but they weren't going to rip his heart out. So when Cortez lands, he gets whispers. I love rumors. He gets rumors of a couple pale skinned guys with beards being part of this tribe. So he sends word, and these guys escape and meet up with him.
Yeah.
I love rumors.
But yeah, so, and like, dude, mind you, Cortez doesn't have like a military background. Like, dude,
dude, he doesn't.
These guys fucking land, they set up their colony, they meet this fucking priest who can kind of fucking translate for them.
Yeah, he learns how to, 8 years of captivity, he learns one of the Mayan languages.
Right.
Yeah.
So, the fucking crew is basically carrying this team. Like, they're like the fucking fighters and soldiers are basically like, dude, things are turning out not bad. We're like winning these, dude.
Winning feels good, man.
It feels good. They beat some of the coastal natives that were there, and they keep on marching. They make it official land of the Spanish crown, so he owes a quinto of what they make from, or what they fucking steal and pillage from, like, those first kind of little tribes that they encounter. And they make their way to Tabasco. And that's where they meet the Tabascans, where they just, like,
concede after
they're that. Like, Ty, dude, like, it's cool. And just don't kill us. Like,
that's the other thing, like, what you're saying, these, like, these people, a lot of these tribes were already, like, opposed to the Aztecs. They're like, dude, I hear what they do up there, dude.
They're all, like, warring with each other. Or yes, they yes, have yes. various alliances.
Right.
Yeah.
But the Tabascans, they concede. They bring them gifts and show them a ton of, like, a shit ton of gold. Just like, please, I hope you guys like these and you don't fucking slit our throats. That'd be great if we could just, you know, stick around for little Turtle Run's third birthday that's coming up here.
Where did he land again? I'm sorry.
They landed
Veracruz.
Yes, that's right. That's right. Yeah.
Okay, so something we skipped over was rumors go all the way back to the Aztecs, and they sent diplomats down.
Yeah, dude. Yeah.
So they sent diplomats down to meet with Cortez, and they bring him a bunch of gold and some gifts. And
from Moctezuma,
Moctezuma specifically,
he's got spies all over the fucking
place.
Yeah.
And this is what I thought was hilarious: is Cortez goes, "Do you have much gold?"